thanks for taking the time to speak with me. First things first, man, how's your day going?
I'm doing great, man. Everything's fine. Yeah? Everything's good. Yeah.
Sweet. Wait, bigger picture then, though. Got to ask you, COVID era, how you been holding up over the last year?
I'm fine with that, too, man. I don't really go out or anything anyway unless I'm on tour. So unless there's a special band I want to go see or something. But, you know, I don't mind being at home, so I've been fine. It's been a little crazy last year dealing with all the shit here in America, you know, but the political side. But, you know, everything's been fine though, man.
Yeah, yeah, across the waters, we sometimes watch you guys from afar and think, what the hell is going on? But we got our own crap to deal with in the UK, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I know. Yeah, it must be pretty entertaining, though, to watch last year, especially. But, I know everybody's got their own problems, so.
Fair days. Well, but considering it is, like I said, a very negative situation, and that tends to be what gets focused on, do you have anything positive in the last year that's happened to you or you've done that you want to share, so a bit of a positive message?
I mean, this album is a positive thing, you know, but I was kept busy last year. I did a band called Dead End America with Nick Oliveri and this guy Slayer Hippie from Poison Idea, who actually passed away, but that wasn't positive, but the record is. We put out a record. I did vocals with this band Hara. I don't know. I just tried to keep busy last year, you know, so all that's good, positive stuff. You know?
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. But that downtime, man, considering like you're talking, you guys did 3 solid years pretty much of touring and then you just hit this long period of downtime. Have you kind of got used to that yet?
I'm never used to, I mean, I love being at home, but I like to play on stage though. You know, I like to be on tour. So, yeah, I mean, it was much needed time at home. You know, we needed that. And we were going to take off last year anyway, the rest of the year. We got home from the Napalm Death Tour, and then we were going to take the rest of the year off, like, and I was going to do the vocals and all that for this album. But it ended up being a lot longer than we expected. But, yeah, I mean, it's kind of nice being at home, but I miss being on stage, you know.
No, that's fair enough. And, man, we want you back in the UK. It's been, as you say, it's been over a year since you were here with Napalm Death. And even longer since your last headline shows. When you're in the UK, do you enjoy it here? Because we love you guys.
Of course. I love it there. I love it. I've got a lot of friends over there. And we've been going there since 92, 93, so we always love it there.
Yeah, we love you over here as well. And the new songs, man, with these new songs, are you looking for, you must be dying to get on stage and air the new songs.
I would love to, man. I would love to play anything, really, but yeah, the new album would be great, you know.
It's going to gel nice. And you made us wait a little while for it, but obviously A History of Nomadic Behaviour is out now. Would this album have come about as quickly as it did had the pandemic hit? Did that speed things up or slow things down?
Well, I mean, like you said, you had to wait a little bit because, I mean, we don't like tour, then put an album out, then tour again. We're not one of those bands, you know. We kind of just do things the way we want to. We just put an album out when we feel we have the right songs and when we want to put it out. We don't listen to record labels and all that nonsense. Yeah. But I forgot your question. But it's
would it have slowed? Would the pandemic hitting when it did? Did it speed up the album or would it have slowed it down? Do you think?
Well, no, the album was recorded in 2018. The music was, but it actually, like I said, we were going to take time off, so it actually like forced some time off, and I did the vocals in July of last year. So it kind of just gave us that space to do that, you know, finish it and mix it and all that stuff and do the artwork and all that, which we hadn't had time to do because of all the touring before.
Oh, so it gave you a little bit of time to take, a little chance to take your time and get it, I guess, as perfect as you want, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh,
yeah.
Banging. What about fan feedback? Do you pay much attention to that sort of thing? You know, the feedback in the album? Because it's been universally positive.
Yeah, I mean, I try not to read every review, though, because, you know, you don't want to sit there and read all the, if there's something bad, you don't want to see that. But yeah, I mean, everything I've seen so far has been great. You know, it's been fantastic. So I'm really happy with that.
No, that's good. That's good. And of course, I mean, there's some new territory touched upon on this album view, the feelings that you've expressed in many of the songs. Was that a kind of thing that you just needed to get out and you would just needed to get like it's out?
Yeah, possibly. But a lot of these lyrics were written way before the like last year, before like all the protests and things happened. I've felt that way my whole life. Okay. I've always been anti-cops and pro, you know, human rights, you know. So I guess some of that kind of creeped out more so, you know, because of last year maybe. But it also, yeah, I guess it's more noticeable now. If 2020 had been a normal year and I did the same lyrics, I don't think anyone would have noticed, you know.
Yeah, so you're getting, so yeah, you didn't necessarily plan it to coincide with the events of 2020. It just slammed together by accident, really.
Yeah, and like I said, a lot of those lyrics were written way before, you know, this thing, all this stuff happened. So it kind of just fit perfectly, though.
Yeah.
Everybody's asking me, everybody's like, are you guys political now? And I'm like, no, we're... But I mean, some of it's like subliminal. It's like things just, you know, they probably came out of me because of what was going on, but it wasn't done on purpose, you know?
Yeah. I mean, I get what you're saying. You're not singing in a song saying screw the bloody president or screw cops and stuff like that. It's subliminal, as you said. But you are right. And it was going to be a question I was going to ask you. The hardcore I Hate God fan base starts rising up and saying, oh my God, you've gone political. I mean, clearly you're not, but that doesn't bother you either.
No, I don't care. I don't care. It's just, it's my words. It's my thoughts, you know, and I don't care what people think, you know.
No, that's completely fair. And, you know, when you do kind of get to express those feelings as you, however it is, be it subliminal or more in your face, if that's what you want to do, is it simply a matter of next time around, there'll be a new load of stuff pissing me off, or I'll just continue where I left off?
I mean, it all depends, you know. I write all the time, you know. I've got notebooks full of writing. I've got writing on my phone, writing on my computer, you know. So, I mean, I just take from those lyrics whatever sounds good to the music they give me, you know.
Yeah, fair enough. That's...
So who knows what the next album, what the lyrics would be like, you know. Yeah, I'm sure it'll be similar, though.
Yeah, I mean, I love that. So it's kind of like notebooks everywhere. You wake up in the middle of the night, and you're like, I've got something jotted down.
I do that. Yeah, I do that.
I mean, your vocals are incredible on this record. You're spitting absolute fire. What do you do, man, to keep your voice in top condition?
Scream at my girlfriend. No, not really. I don't know, man. Smoke, you know? I mean, that's about it. I don't know. I just do it, you know?
Brilliant.
I thought the vocals on this record are a lot more subdued than some of the older ones, but the older records, it was more of like drunken stream of consciousness, kind of speaking in tongues stuff. You know, this one was more, you know, straightforward, I guess.
Yeah, but when I hear it and when I've listened to it, the word snarl, that's what comes into my head constantly, man. I say spitting fire, where it's just like, okay, this is, you're directly screaming in my ears, that kind of thing. Yeah. That's what stands out so much, obviously amongst the music as well.
Yeah, I would say it's more focused, I guess, you know, more evolved than some of the... I mean, there's times, I mean, this band hasn't cared a lot in the past. Mm. We still don't really care, but, you know, on some of the other albums, it was, we just went and did it in like one take and that was it. You know, there was a little more time and focus on this record.
A little more polish, as it were. Yeah.
Maybe so. Yeah.
Yeah. But that's the thing. You can say that and I can say my piece, but it is undoubtedly an I Hate God record. There's no craziness here.
That's what I hope, you know, I mean, no matter what we do, it should sound like I Hate God, you know?
Yeah. How are you? Yeah. How are you these days then, holding up and hanging on when it comes to the likes of social media and the demands that fans have for you to be online, putting stuff out? Do you like that aspect of it?
I don't love it, to be honest. It's not my favorite thing, you know. I mean, But I mean, I deal with it, you know, and it's sometimes it can be fun, you know, it just depends on what it is. I mean, I try to do things like the record label comes at me with these things like, can you do this? And like, you know, whatever. So, I mean, I'll do stuff, you know, that it's fun. But then, I'll post like an old picture or something. It's entertaining, you know, just to see what people are going to say. And it's, I don't know, it is what it is.
It's interaction, isn't it? You know, people just want to see you on there. Doesn't really matter what you're posting.
I guess so, yeah. But especially with last year, you know, and now with no social interaction at all out and, you know, with the shows or anything. So it's kind of a good thing right now. It's helpful.
No, that's cool. That's cool. And what else, like right now, what else is keeping you busy? Because obviously the album's out, you're doing your promotion stuff, you're doing your interviews and stuff, but what else is going on with you now?
Just lately, it's been interviews and interviews and interviews, you know, just for the past like month, I've just been doing these Zoom interviews all over the place. And that's the latest thing that's just, you know, that's keeping me busy.
Are you sick of talking about the album yet?
It depends on the questions, you know. I mean, you're asking some okay stuff. It's like some of them are so generic that, you know, you kind of, it's just like, wow, why are you have me here right now. Why ask me something, you know, I don't know. But I don't get sick of it. It's, you know, it's part of the job. It's part of being in a band, you know, it's fun.
Yeah, that's what I gather it is. Yeah, it can be fun, but as you say, it is part of the job, so to speak, even if you've never seen, that's a question in, have you ever seen I Hate God as a job?
No, not really as a job. We always have fun doing everything. I mean, if it is a job, it's a fun one. Mm. You know, I mean, me and Jimmy Bauer always said if it stops being fun, then we're probably not gonna do it anymore, you know, because it's been fun for 30 plus years. We've been having a good time with it, you know.
But your fun always seems to come more when you're on stage than perhaps in the studio, do you reckon?
Yeah, I mean, the studio is okay, you know, but I definitely think we're a live band, you know.
Yeah,
I think
yeah.
We have more fun on stage, and it's looser, and it's not so regimented, you know, as far as the studio.
Does that fun on stage come from the fact that you look out and you've got that sweating, heaving mass of people knocking away to your music?
Yeah, of course. I mean, that's one of the best things about it. You know, playing in a smaller club that's oversold, you know, the fire marshals are trying to shut it down, and everybody's just drunk and sweaty and crazy. And that's another reason I don't think we could do a live stream like a lot of bands are doing. I mean, we've talked about it, and we're just like, should we do a live stream? But I don't know, man. I don't know. There's not, that energy is going to be lacking somewhere, and I don't want to do like a bad show or boring show on just with a camera there, you know.
I get it. I've watched my fair few live streams of the year, varying different styles of bands, from the heaviest of the heavy to the softer, and it can be an odd experience. Have you kind of sat back and watched any?
I haven't really watched any, to be honest. You know, I haven't. I don't know. I just. There's a couple I wanted to see, but I didn't. I wasn't like thrilled enough to go pay for it and watch it. You know, I don't know.
No, that's fair. What about what about this opportunity? Now, this is something I'm not sure this happens in America, but it's something that happened here and will be happening again in the next couple of months, which is what we call socially distanced live shows. So it's live in a bar, in a pub, in a small venue, but 50% capacity and everybody has to stay seated. Would you want to do it? Sounds weird as hell, right?
Yeah.
Would you?
I don't know. I mean, I guess we would, if we have to do that, we will, but that's just not that fun. I mean, we've played shows where everybody sat down and just was real polite and watched us, you know, but I don't think, you know, it would take away from it a bit, I think.
Oh, I kind of want to experience that now, just once. It'd be weird just to be an I Hate God gig and it be completely seated and everybody giving you a round of applause at the end of a song.
Yeah. I mean, we've definitely played shows like in Japan, you know, like that, where people are just very polite and they clap. But, but I mean, you know, it would be strange.
Yeah, man, you kind of forget as well just how you've been all over the world. Is there anywhere that you can think of at the top of your head, you know what, we've not played there? That's still on our bucket list after so many bloody years.
Yeah, like Uzbekistan or somewhere, you know, we could always go there. Siberia or something.
Yeah.
I don't know. I always think like, where can we go next that will have us, you know?
Yeah.
And there's definitely places that bands have been that we haven't been. So I want to try to get there, you know?
The pins and the maps, man. It must be, it's full up, but they're still not complete. I get it.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
You know, we're in the UK, we're slowly looking like we might be opening up as the summer goes on. Not sure about America and the rest, man. But I guess, is that where you kind of hope to get back on the road is coming from? Just waiting to see what happens next, right?
Yeah, I mean, we're talking about maybe November, October, November, maybe, you know. It's not set in stone yet, but we have to talk about it now because you have to plan ahead.
Mm.
So whether it gets canceled or not, we don't know, but we're hoping things can happen. You know, that's in America, though. As far as us touring to the UK or to Europe, I don't know, man. They're talking about like a vaccine passport maybe, and I don't know what the borders are going to be like. Yeah. Are we going to have to get like checked at every border? And I don't know, man. So
yeah, it's not as simple as it once was before. And you haven't even taken into account Brexit. The whole, if you were in Europe and then come to the UK for even more difficulty. Yeah.
I've heard that's going to be a problem now, so I don't know.
As always, watch this space. We'll see what happens further down the line in regards to that. Mike, that's it. Thank you so much for your time.
Sure, man. Thank you. It's good talking to you.
Thank you very much for watching. You can check us out on gbhbl.com as well as on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and Tumblr. Go to Patreon to help us out over there. That's patreon.com/GBHBL, as well as Big Cartel, where you can find some of our merchandise. We have a podcast running on SoundCloud and Apple Podcasts. And of course, if you like this video, do us a favor, hit the subscribe button and help the channel grow. Games, horror, and heavy metal. What else is life for?